Hello, here we are making a video to prove that most of the Chinese turbine machines are poor technology. They are not efficient and they are not power saving. We have videos, we have pictures from all the Chinese suppliers. Okay, first of all, we check one video. This is the video I download from YouTube. Is to show the machine made by CSC Power. This is the machine number one, 5 company. This is number two. And there's another one behind here, number three. They are all 5 company turbine machines. Clearly we can see that each machine is equipped with 1 25 horsepower piston compressor, and the compressor has 6 pistons here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that is the 25 horsepower with the piston compressor. Okay, clearly we can see the CSC is using a 25 horsepower compressor for the 5 ton per day turbine machine. Yeah, this is the reading. And then we check some pictures. Yeah, this is the CSC power, 5 ton per day. This is the compressor, 25 horsepower. Okay. This is a 5 ton per day turbine machine made by Kingwell. It's also a 25 horsepower. It's also a 25 horsepower piston compressor. Visa. This is the 5 ton made by Coldmax. Okay. This is the compressor. It has 6 pistons and it's a 25 horsepower compressor. 5 ton per day made by Collar. Again, we can clearly see it made of a 25 horsepower piston compressor. Okay. That's the reason they have to use the bigger compressor to reach the capacity 5 ton per day, because the system is very simple and very poor technology. It's not efficient. That is why they have to use a very big compressor to reach the same capacity. We can see that this machine, it's very, very simple. The supplier simply put the 4 main refrigeration components together. The compressor, the condenser, the evaporator, and expansion valve. They put these 4 components together to form 1 turbine machine. And that is very simple. And that is a very simple system. It's not efficient. It's very poor technology. This kind of system will never be power saving, and the user will be suffering from high electricity consumption every day. Well, the user is going to pay for high electricity bill all the time, and all the profit will be killed. Yeah, we check the CSC power. You can see compressor, condenser behind, and this is the evaporator. This is all we have for the system. 4 main refrigeration components. Okay, this one, compressor, evaporator, condenser, and expansion valve. Finish. That is all they have. this kind of system is not efficient at all. It's very poor technology. And now we check this one. It's the same thing. Compressor, condenser, evaporator, and that is all we have. This is the reading of CDFI 500. The ice is not so solid and it's milky white. That is not perfect. Okay, here is the 25 horsepower piston compressor with the 6 pistons. So this piston is not efficient either. It's simple and poor technology. Oh, one more reason, and one more thing. You can see the machine is made out of carbon steel frame with painting. That is not good for making food quality ice tubes. We should use stainless steel. Yeah, ice floss, that is CDFI. The ice is not 100% transparent crystal. It's not good at all. And it has very bigger in the hole. So the ice is easily to be crushed. And there's a reason why the ice is milky white. Because the system's evaporating temperature is always out of control. It's always very low. So the water is getting frozen very rapidly. And the bubble, the air bubbles, cannot be released from the water when it was getting frozen. Okay, so this is all I want to show to prove about the Chinese tube ice machines. Yes, we are checking all the 5 company tube ice machines made by all those suppliers. Thanks.